Round 8 proved to be the comeback weekend with two former AFL players starring for their TSL sides. Former Melbourne defender Colin Garland made his anticipated return to the Demons of North Hobart and had an immediate effect, leading from the front to help the young Demons upset the fancied Tigers in one of the boilovers of the season. Another former Melbourne Demon and North Launceston Premiership coach, Tom Couch, also made his return, booting 5 to help the Northern Bombers smash their crosstown rivals by 53 points. Jake Cox always looks home at the tip, and Round 8 was no exception, snagging 3 to help the Roos come from behind to clinch the Eastern Shore bragging rights for the second time this season. Things got heated between Lauderdale and Glenorchy in Round 9, but it was the home side that dealt with the heat the best, recording an impressive 33-point win with Tim Mosquito and Ryan Wiggins leading the way. Launceston veteran Sonny Whiting turned Demon Slayer in Round 9, booting a bag of 6, including his 400th goal for the club, en route to a big Launceston win on the road. The Tigers gave the ladder leaders an enormous scare at Utaz Stadium, kicking 5 consecutive goals in the final term, including this sizzler from Eddie Burrows Chang to get within striking distance. Zach Burr took to the heavens, however, to seal the deal for the reigning premiers. The Bombers were flying in Round 10, outrunning the informed Blues to record a 30-point win and announce themselves as the team to watch for 2018. Phil Bell Chambers had everyone ducking in a typically strong display, while Josh McGinnis again starred for the Bombers, although Dylan Riley finished the day with bragging rights after this sensational grab. The Northern Bombers got revenge on the Magpies at KG5 in Round 10, overcoming a low-scoring start via the explosiveness of Zach Burt, while Josh Ponting continued his strong start to the season with another eye-catching display. The emergence of Ryan Bailey was again on full display as the Roos took care of the Demons at Blunston Arena. The big man kicked 4 to help the Roos remain at the pointy end of the ladder. The walking highlight reel, that is Jake Cox, was at his devastating best at Windsor Park in Round 11, combining with Chris Neal to stun the Blues and take 4 valuable points back down the highway. While Tiger star Blake Grant hit the scoreboard with a blinder at KG5, it was the Glenorchy Magpies who ruled the roost in Round 11, running out 26-point winners. Mitch Rainbird took to the sky for the Pies, while Matthew Joseph became a dangerous avenue to goal with a haul of 5. The reigning premiers were clinical in dismantling the Demons at Utaz Stadium, with several Bombers lodging their claim for a ticket to the FIFA World Cup in Russia. Clarence and North Launceston played out a thriller in Round 12, trading blows throughout the afternoon in a high-quality affair. Clarence big man Ryan Bailey had 3 chances to be the hero in a tight finish, but made the most of the last to help the Roos make a statement and clinch a stirring win over the reigning premiers. The Jay Bowden Show took over North Hobart Oval, with the Magpies stalwart kicking 8 in a dominant Glenorchy victory. Alex Hill and Phil Bell Chambers led the way for the victorious Bombers at a wet Twin Ovals after Henry Kerenayu lit the spark with a crafty finish. The Magpies sent the Roos crashing back down to earth in Round 13, kicking 10 goals to 3 in the opening half to set up a big 53-point win. Daniel Joseph was prolific for the Pies out of defence, while Jay Bowden was up to his usual tricks with 4. It was pocket rocket Callan Daly, however, who provided the biggest spark, snapping a beauty from the KG5 pocket. The Tigers stunned Launceston in one of the boilovers of the season in Round 13, getting off to a fast start and holding on in a low-scoring tussle at Twin Ovals. Blake McCulloch proved dangerous inside forward 50. The Bombers did what they had to do against North Hobart, and while the Flying Mullet again took to the skies, Sam Collins did his best World Cup impression with a beauty from the pocket. Glenorchy's good form continued at home in Round 14, this time accounting for the Blues by 48 points. The Magpies skipped away to a comfortable lead and never looked back, getting revenge on the Blues after a narrow loss earlier in the season. The Roos and Tigers engaged in a high-scoring shootout early at Blunston Arena, trading blows in an entertaining start to the contest before the Troy Cunliffe-led Roos hit the accelerator in the second half to record a comfortable win. The Battle of the Bombers resumed at Utaz Stadium, with the reigning premiers seeing off a strong challenge by last year's grand finalists to further cement top spot. The Launceston Derby delivered one of the games of the season in Round 15, with the fast-finishing Bombers clinching a thrilling 1-point win under Friday night lights. Dylan Riley was influential inside 50 for the Blues, but the Bombers did just enough to come back from behind and clinch a nail-biting win. The return of Thor Boscott sparked Lauderdale to action against the Roos in Round 15, propelling the Bombers to the prestigious State Chatty Cup. Tim Mosquito's dynamic three-goal effort earned him the State Chatty Medal as Darren Winter's men claimed Easton Shore bragging rights once again. Tigers got revenge on the Demons at North Hobart Oval in round 15 with Mitch Carter's long bomb giving the Tiger Army plenty to cheer about. The Flying Mullet was unleashed in round 16 with Lauderdale star Ben McGuinness kicking 7 goals to fuel a bomber blitz against the travelling Magpies. Roller Cali Mansell sparked the Blues back into action, helping Launceston slay the Demons and record their first win since round 9. Meanwhile, the Northern Bombers marked skipper Bradcock's Goodyear's 150th game in style with a big win over the Tigers.